wrote the song. Thoughts become action, tell me what's happening. What's your mind wrapped in? Wrapped around, wrapped around, wrapped around.
How's it going, guys? Welcome to FM Nation, and you're listening to Jamie, and you're watching the Parma Resurrection. This is the second episode of the third season. We're currently in the Serie B, and in today's episode, we're going to be playing Latina, who are sitting 11th in the Serie B, one place ahead of us. We're 12th. Let's have a quick look at the league table. So we're going to be playing Latina at this point in the season. It's kind of five games in. Title's still quite tight. The league table's still quite tight. Sorry, my phone and my tablet's notifications are going off in the background. They're kind of putting me off a wee bit. The table's still quite tight at this point in the season. So a win would be good. It would help set us up for a good wee run in the league. Help us kind of keep a good standing. I think after the first 10 games, you kind of get a feel for who's going to be the good teams and who's going to be the teams going up, who's going to be kind of battling relegation, etc. So we want to get off to a good start. Since our last episode against Catanzaro, a very disappointing 5-2 defeat. We've played four games, which was we lost 3-2 to Navarro. Which was kind of bittersweet, really, because we were 3-0 down at half time. It was very disappointing. I was thinking, oh no, this Serie B is going to be extremely difficult. But in the second half, I gave them a bit of a bollocking at half time, and they responded well in the second half. Came back out, scored a goal within 10 minutes, brought one back. Then we were kind of the better team, and then Insignia scored on the 83rd minute, but it was a little bit kind of too little too late sort of thing. We gave ourselves too much to do, really, being 3-0 down at half time. So although I was happy with the second half performance, we showed a bit of character. We still lost, we gave ourselves too much to do. We went and played Spal, after these two games here, I put the team on defensive training, so we kind of a high intensity, because we were getting goals, we were scoring goals, but we were conceding as well. So the change in training kind of helped. It looked as if it has helped. We beat Spal 4-1, goals from Di Roberto, and then a goal from Insignia and Alborno as well. We went and played Juve Stabia, beat them 3-0. Again, we're getting the goals. The goals aren't a problem. It's just the conceding. So that game is pleasing for us, that we kept a clean sheet. Two goals from Dennis Rosato and a goal from Stefano Padovan. And then we went and played Lecce away from home. 3-1 defeat. That's another one that was a little bit kind of, obviously, disappointed to lose, but Lecce aren't a bad team. Over the past kind of 10-15 years, they've been in and out of the Serie A, kind of yo-yoing between Serie A and Serie B, so they're not a bad team. And obviously we're Parma, but we're kind of recovering Parma, so they're a bit like kind of Phil Mitchell. He was a hard man back in his day, but he's kind of recovering alcoholic now. That's a bit like us. We're Parma, we're a hard man back in our day, but we're a bit like a recovering alcoholic nowadays. We're not quite what we used to be. So that's a comparison you'll never hear ever again. That's a comparison you'll never hear. Parma and Parma likened to Phil Mitchell, I guarantee that. You'll never hear anything like that. Only here, guys, only here. So I'll stop talking shite for a wee second. We'll go in, we'll check our transfers, transfer history. Since the last episode, there's only been three bits of transfer news, and that is that we sent out Antonio Romano on loan, because he wasn't getting the games here that he was that we were hoping that it would. And to be fair, to be brutally honest, potential abilities dropped as well. So I don't see him having a big future with us. But I didn't want him being unhappy and not getting games, so I just sent him on loan. And also, we sold Agostino Camigliano, who was, he was kind of an important big player for us, an important player for us, but he's, I mean, left back and centre back, so quite versatile. Could cover in a few positions for us. He's right footed, so he also played right back a few times for us. But we got offered £1 million cash straight up for him. So I couldn't turn that down, not with the financial situation that we've got going on. We're still £3 million in debt after that. But we brought in a replacement for him, Eduardo Lanzini, on a free transfer, 24 years old, same age as Camigliano roughly. And he's a centre back, and his star rating's the same as Camigliano as well. But if you look at his stats, he's less versatile. But if you look at his stats, I think he's a better central defender than what Camigliano was. So I'm happy with those, and we got him for free, and he's valued at £1.4 million immediately. So that's brilliant, you know. And quickly, actually, I keep clicking away from him, then having to go back. But quickly, he's played 3 games for us, and his average rating is 27.23, which is a great start for somebody who's not really, who's kind of still trying to get back to full fitness, or was, but he's getting there now after the 3 games. So David Bassi, he got injured not long after the first game against Catanzaro. I think he played the game against Catanzaro, he got injured, and he was out for quite a while with a hernia. He'll be back in a week's time. Also, Andrea Bandini, our right back, star right back, he's been injured for the past week or so. Got a groin strain, couple of kind of 5 days he's been injured for, but he's out for another 2 weeks. So that's quite a blow for us. But Satalinos came in and played pretty well for the goalkeeping injury. He's took over Bassi for the past 5 games, and he's had an average rating of 7.34 over the last 5 games, which has been good. That's good. It's a good good fella. In fact, he'll probably stay in there until his form drops, actually, even though Bassi's a first choice. Satalino's taking his chance, and I think it's only fair to kind of let him have a run in the game, run in the team, so long as his form keeps up. We've been playing Kilcagney in that right back instead of Bandini because of his injury. He's not listed as a right back, but he's been filling in pretty well. An average rating at 6.84, which is not bad, to be fair, considering it's not his position. We did have a right back called Matteo Beltrami, who was our cover for him, for Bandini, but we sent him out on loan. Typically, when you send out your cover on loan, typically what happens is they get injured, and that's what's happened. So kind of been FM'd by FM, really. But we will miss Bandini over the next couple of weeks. So yeah, other than that though, there's really no news. There's really nothing other than to get into the game. But that £1 million that we sold Camigliano for put a big dent in the club's debt. And obviously we didn't get much of it for the transfer budget. If you look at the right hand side there, we've only got £70,000 for the transfer budget, or £69,000 if you want to be pernickety. But we're kind of trying to keep a cap on the wage budget, so we're under our wage budget, which is good. So things are all in order, really. So all we've really got to do now is get into the game. So we've got Latina in a day's time, so I'll get to the match screen, team selection screen. I'll go through it quickly. I'll go through the team selection very quickly, and then we'll get into the game.
All right, guys, so here we are at the squad submission screen.
This is the formation I've been playing recently in this season. This formation's all about movement in the final third. Padovan there playing as a deep line forward, so he's dropping deep, kind of causing a little bit of havoc for the two central defenders if they kind of giving them something to think about, whether they follow him or just let him go drop into the space. And we've got the three shadow strikers here overlapping him, so he's kind of the main man to kind of play people in there. We've got the two kind of all action midfielders, deep line central midfielders, ball winning midfielder, and a deep line playmaker. And we've got the full backs on automatic, so they're just kind of there to give possession options to the midfielders and the defenders. So yeah, it's quite a good tactic. It's worked pretty well so far, although we've lost 3 games out of 5. It's done as well in the cup and that as well. So and I think they're still kind of just kind of trying to get to grips with it. But this is the team. We've got Calcagna there filling in for Bandini, Satellino filling in for Bassi. I've got Eduardo Lancini, the new signing, and kind of creating a good partnership with Arlen Dajeti, the Albanian centre-back who starred for Albania in the Euros there. I've got Rodrigo Albano, our Paraguayan left-back, Iniguez, who is a Uruguayan, no it's not, Argentinian, I'm talking rubbish, an Argentinian centre midfielder, alongside Gasperoni in centre midfield. And we've got Lucas Castro, who's Argentinian. Yes, correct, he's Argentinian. You got that one right, well done Jamie, you know your players. And Lorenzo Insigne, not Lorenzo Insigne in fact, Roberto Insigne, the not so good little brother, but he's good in this, he's good for us. We've got Rosato playing alongside him, and then we've got Stefano Padovan, who's taken Marco Dabro's place, and he's done quite a good job to be fair. Dabro came in, he's had a slow start to the season, so I mean I'm quite harsh that way, I'm not very loyal to my players. If they're playing badly I'll drop them, it doesn't matter who it is, they'll get dropped if they're not performing. So Padovan is in, he's took his chance. So yeah, we've got, if you look at the last this bar here, the last 5 games here, all of our players are kind of above 7 except for Calcagni, but he's playing out of position and he's not playing too badly, so I'm not too worried. Yeah, so that's the team for this game. We'll get in the kickoff and we will see you during the game. Alright,
here we are playing against Latina, the team that sounds like something you would type into your U-Porn search bar.
Here we are, 25 minutes in, it's first highlight, Calcagni gets the ball in, and Gian, I'm going to slow that down a little bit, it's going a bit fast. But Gasperoni here on the ball, driving out wide, plays inside to Iniguez, then Lancini is going to go long into the corner for Castro, but Bani picks up, but Castro wins the ball back, a slide tackle, can he get the ball into the box? He does, Rosato's there and it's a save by the goalkeeper, I didn't see his name, but it's a good save, and that's it, didn't come to anything there.
Bani with the throw in at the left back. Left side, Bani gets the ball out wide again, plays it to Clemenza, inside to Amari, is it? Amari? Najib Amari, and he puts Latina 1-0 up, and it's not an ideal start to be fair. Alex Zapata, it's a tackle there, it's a terrible tackle apparently, because it's a red card, and hopefully that gives us a little bit of a inroad back into the game.
Satellino goes long,
It's been headed clear, but Castro picks up and plays it wide to Calcagni. What's he going to do? Can he take his man on there? He's got to be able to take him on. He gets a good ball in and Castro's there, and it's a save by Pinsolio. It looks like we're going to go in at half time 1-0 down. We've got Lancini here, plays it to Rosato. Wide to Albano, gets the ball inside, but Clemenza picks it up for Valle. He's driving with it, come on guys, put a tackle in somebody. Got Vitali there, Ciano to Amari, and it's unbelievable, we're getting beat 2-0 after 10 men, unbelievable.
Alright, so it's half time here, they're down to 10 men, I'm having a quick look at their tactics here.
They look as if they're going to stick with one up front with two attacking midfielders. I'm going to go for a tactical change. I was going to start with a 4-4-2, but I thought that us being at home, we could kind of get away with playing the tactics that we've been playing, but it's not been working. We've not been, and since they've went down to 10, we've not made the extra man count. So I'm going to change to 4-4-2, and hopefully they can use the wings. We can exploit the flanks, and hopefully kind of give them some problems. Give them something else to think about. I'll make the tactical changes, and we'll see you at the second half. All right.
Here we are in the second half. We've went 4-4-2. We're hoping we can salvage something from the game. We've got Vitali on the ball here. He plays it to Favalli. Ciano into Amari. Hits the post. I mean, nearly went 3-0 down, and that would have been game over. I can't believe we're struggling against 10 men so badly. Clear Clemenza into Vitali. To Amari. Plays it to Ciano. And he's offside. We really need to get a grip in this game. We're doing nothing to turn it around.
Alright, we brought on Nunzio Di Roberto for Dennis Rosato. He's not been playing very well. I'm hoping we need a goal really in the next kind of 10 minutes for any hope of salvaging anything. We've had 8 shots in target to their 2 shots in target, so we're actually currently being FM'd at the moment, which is quite hard to take. I'm going to make another sub. I'm going to get Marco Dabro in for Padovan, who's having an absolute stinker. But nobody's really playing very well, to be fair. We'll just get him on quickly, and hopefully he can do something. I'm going to change the crosses to floated rather than low, because Dabro's got a bit of height about him, so we're hoping we can kind of hit him, hit some early crosses, go a little bit more direct. There we go. Hopefully that can do something for us in the last 10 minutes. We've got Amari running with the ball there. He's caused us so many problems this game. Ciano plays to Amari again. Ciano to Sansoni. Plays to Ciano. And again, I don't know what's happening. Our defenders aren't picking up runners. There's nobody picking up runners there. They're just standing watching. Look at that. Nobody picking up the runner. Getting the wrong side of the man every time. Every time they've scored here, we've been the wrong side of the man. Which is just not good enough. A 3-0 hammering, actually. It's been an absolute doon. We've had 10 shots in target, but I mean, it means nothing if you don't put any of them away. I don't know where the shots have been coming from. I don't know if they've been long shots or, because we've not had any highlights, so I mean, I don't know, it's quite disappointing, really. A big game, 10 men as well, 10 men as well, we're getting beat off 10, absolutely destroyed off of 10 men. I'm absolutely livid, I'm absolutely fuming at this. I can't believe we're playing so badly. I'm absolutely fucking fuming with that, cannot believe it, absolutely gutted with that. I don't know what to say about that. In fact, they're getting the silent treatment. Fuck them, they're getting the silent treatment. Nothing is being said at all. I'm just going straight to the, I'm taking the huff with them. I can't believe 10 men, we've been beat 3-0, outclassed by 10 men. Absolutely raging with that. So that leaves us, looking at that table there, it leaves us 16th in the league. That was a golden opportunity to climb the table there, and we've found ourselves kind of six or seven spaces off the drop, so off the bottom of the league rather. Disappointing there, very disappointing. All I can do is apologise for that performance. I'm going to kind of look to try and turn it round over the next five games. We'll play the next five off screen. Crotone, Cittadella, Pescara, Trapani, sorry, I've got wind coming up. Crotone, Cittadella, Pescara, Trapani, Ascoli. I'll play those five games off screen, and we'll come back for the Vicenza game, which is a derby match if I remember correctly. Is it a derby? No, they're just a rival, a local rival. So we'll come back for the local rivals match against Vicenza. Very quick shout out, though. Should have done it at the beginning of the episode, but I just forgot. quick shout out to McGilvery FM, who's got a really good, channel, and he's just started a series that looks like it's going to be promising. It's called The Pride of Nottingham. It's about Notts County, bringing them up, bringing them up to the same level as Nottingham Forest. Hopefully, I hope he does that. Hope he replicates or even exceeds Nottingham Forest's European exploits in the 80s. I'm hoping he can do something like that with him. But if you're not already watching him, go over and check him out. I'll put a link in the description. Another thing is the FM Addicts community on Facebook. I'd highly recommend, if you're not already in that, go into it. It's a good group. A lot of people sharing a lot of good content in there. I'll put the link in the description for it, for the Facebook group. I highly recommend that you get in there and kind of see what everybody's saying. People put up a lot of stuff, a lot of content, and it's quite good. It's a good group. Everybody likes to have a laugh in it as well. It's not too serious, which is good. But again, thanks for watching. If you're not already subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Drop a wee like if you liked the video, and leave a comment if you've got anything to say. But until the Vicenza game, we'll see you next time. All right, take care. Bye bye.